Today I'm taking up four questions we're frequently asked about overhead cranes. Welcome to Rigging Cues. My name is Ben, and this is the Lifting and Rigging Channel. Today I'm answering your questions about overhead cranes. Remember, you're the lift director here. If you have a question you want answered, drop it in the comments below. First question, does someone who assembles and disassembles portable gantry cranes and equipment need to be qualified as the OSHA 1926 standard states, even though this will be used in a general industry environment, which falls under OSHA 1910? CMAA 78-2 technical qualification states a crane technician is any person engaging in repairing, troubleshooting, maintaining, servicing, and functional testing of cranes, including but not limited to top running and under running bridge and gantry type single or double girder overhead traveling cranes and associated hoisting equipment. And a crane technician must be qualified under the CMAA 78-2 technical qualification standard. ASME B32 Overhead and Gantry Crane states that new, reinstalled, altered, repaired, and modified equipment shall be inspected prior to the initial use to verify compliance with the applicable provisions of Chapter 2-1. It also states that new, reinstalled, altered, repaired, and modified cranes shall be tested by a designated person prior to initial use to confirm that the crane performs in compliance with the provisions of this volume and that reinstalled, altered, repaired, and modified cranes shall be load tested prior to initial use unless otherwise determined by a qualified person. So the answer is yes. Someone who assembles and disassembles portable gantry cranes and equipment needs to be qualified under CMAA 78, and after the installation, the portable gantry crane needs to be inspected by a qualified person, undergo operational tests by the qualified person, and receive a load test unless a qualified person determines otherwise. Where might one look for used overhead crane systems? When consulting with your local crane manufacturer, ask if they have access to any used crane systems. Some manufacturers have a stockpile of previously owned crane systems in case someone is interested. You can also typically buy used crane and hoist equipment through used industrial machine brokers, equipment or heavy machine auctions, scrap or salvage yards, or third-party sellers on sites like Craigslist or eBay. But buyers beware. Not all overhead crane systems can easily be retrofitted from one application to another. We have a great article and video on new versus used overhead cranes linked in the description below. How does building access affect the cost of an overhead crane? Building access is probably the biggest factor that impacts the installation cost of an overhead crane. Cranes are long. Trucks need to be able to pull into your facility with the crane and then get the crane into your building. If you don't have adequate turning radiuses, then the crane may need to be shipped in smaller pieces and assembled on site, or the site itself might need to be modified to allow access. This should be noted during the planning stages, and a good overhead crane salesperson or account manager will be able to include any difficulties in your initial quote. Would OSHA approve a 2,000-ton jib crane with a 1,000-ton trolley and a 3,000-ton hoist? All components are clearly marked with capacity. What is the max capacity that can be applied? Yes, it is okay, but the operator must be trained to determine the maximum load for the system and not exceed the lowest rated component, in this case being 1,000 tons. If you're looking for more information on any of these topics, check out the links in the description. We also have a ton of information on anything overhead crane related in our learning center at mozellacompanies.com. My name is Ben, and I'll see you in the next one.